Hey guys, welcome back to this brand new video. Today I'm going to do a beginner's tutorial in Photoshop. I'm going to do this in more parts, and in each part I will run through every of these tools right here. So in this first episode I'm going to go through this tool here, which is the move tool. But before beginning anything, I'm going to show you how to set up our new file, most partly. So for every file you actually basically want to make, you want to be sure that the settings are pretty similar to these. So I'm going to start off here. With the name, if you already have the name of the file in head, then you can do that, but I always do this at the end. Then we go over to the width and the height. Now in any case, be sure this is on pixels. There are some options there, but you have to be sure it's on pixels. And the size for thumbnails and videos in any case is 920 by 1080 pixels. Okay, so then we move on to the resolution. The resolution is 300, which is pretty much the max nowadays, I believe. But in any case, it's pretty high, and it's what I really advise you to have in pixel/inch, by the way. The color mode is RGB, and it's around 60 bits I would advise you to use. Then you can do the background content. It could be white, black, background color that you choose. Transparent, I just do other, and I don't know, I made it white, just like that. And for the rest, not really that important. And so here we are. As you can see, I have here the move tool selected. And we are going to go down here to the layers. As you can see, this image right here is the background, because it's like the only thing here, so it has to be the background. I'm going to unlock it by double clicking it, no matter where. Double click it, and as you can see, it will automatically make it a layer zero. So now what you can do, basically this tool allows you to, you can just move it like this, and you can move it just like this. That is one thing, of course, that's the main idea behind this tool. It's to move the item wherever you want. But the other important part is that you can have multiple images at the same time. And if you do this, you don't necessarily touch the image you want, all right? So that will basically mean that you have to select one of the corners or just around like this. And you click like here, and then you go to the part that you can actually just specifically move this image wherever you want without bothering any other images. So yeah, this is basically for sizing your item, so you can make it like this, whatever. If you want it to be the exact same size, be sure you go up here and select this thing. Now you're sure that at all time, whenever you move it, it's going to be the same size. Like always the same size. This of course is really useful, because you can do this with any item, image, whatever you want. The rest you can do, we can put here the angle. I'm going to say 90 for an example. That's a little bit weird in this case, but anyway, as you can see, you can turn it. You can also, as you can see, if you go along with the image, if you go away a little bit, pretty far away, like this, you can see that it has some two arrow symbol, which means you can just basically rotate it. You know, you can do it with it whatever you want. It even shows you at which angle you are. For example, if I'm like this, I'm like -142.8, blah, blah, you know. This is basically the drill. You can rotate the thing or however you want, and basically if you want, you size it like this. You want to be sure it's in the middle, you know, you're gonna have to do some, yeah, this kind of things, you know. But anyway, it's really useful to use this rotation tool. Definitely recommend it in some cases. So I didn't run through these two here, but they basically are the the location. So the X and the Y is always like where the item is situated. If I put it right here, as you can see, it changed. If I put it right here, changed again, changed here. No, it's basically wherever the item goes, this shows you at which X and Y angle it is. But yeah, I think I showed you the essentials of like the moving tool and everything that comes behind it. Pretty much all the options actually of this tool, and as you can see, it's really useful. Once again, this is a beginner tutorial, so if you are new in the whole Photoshop scene, I'm gonna show you one by one these tools and explain you them like this, like I did here, and what is the use of them, when to use it. Well, I hope you liked this video. If you did, please leave a like, it will be really nice. You could also subscribe, which is also really nice, and I hope to see you in the next video. Goodbye.